you know, of course, photography is a highly technical profession and skill. But at the end of the day, what it really is, it's a way to communicate emotion. And if you're not communicating emotion, I don't know what the point is. Okay, so I've seen a lot of video tutorials on how to take better pictures, what camera to use, what lens to use, all these things. And you do need to have some technical mastery of your craft. In a lot of ways, it just doesn't matter. So rather than just a straight tutorial series, I want to share with you some photos that I've taken over the years that I feel are my best work. And they may not resonate with you in the exact same way that they do with me, but these are highly personal things, and some of them are work photos, some of them are personal photos. But I want to share with you some of the details about the circumstance of the photos and how they actually came about. And where I can, I'll share the technical details with you as well, because that could be a useful point of learning. But ultimately, I want to just talk about the picture itself. And some of these photos are probably considered technically excellent photos, and other ones probably are not. And I'm going to share both kinds with you, because for me, the photo is not always just about the technical execution of the photography aspect of it. I think that, you know, of course, photography is a highly technical profession and skill, but at the end of the day, what it really is, it's a way to communicate emotion. And if you're not communicating emotion, I don't know what the point is. So I chose this photo as the starting point for this series because this was probably the very first moment that I realized the true power of photography in an emotional sense. I think that when I think back to this moment, it still takes me back to the place and the time where this all happened. And I was traveling around Japan. I had just turned 20. I'd spent a few months there, and I had actually intended to live in Japan for a year, but the whole experience was so overwhelming that I just decided I would travel out until I ran out of money. And there's a number of different reasons for that, but it was a formative trip. This was my first big adventure in the world. My mom is Japanese, and I really hadn't taken any interest in being Japanese myself up until this point. So the whole trip was really an emotional journey and a coming of age thing for me, where I was out in the world for the first time. And I think a lot of you can probably relate to that. It's your world becomes very big very quickly as soon as you get out of high school or college and start seeing more than your neighborhood and your country and your street. So this picture, it's not the best photograph ever. And it certainly wasn't taken with any fancy equipment. At the time, I had a basic Minolta SLR camera and nothing too fancy. I'd bought a zoom lens. I don't even remember what the focal length was, but it was probably something like 70 to 150 or 70 to 200, but certainly not a fast lens. It was a very basic thing, and it would have been a huge splurge for me at the time to spend the money on something like that. But it was very hot in Fukuoka and it was very humid. It was mid 30 degrees Celsius, so it was like 35 degrees Celsius, but so humid, really just sticky and kind of gross conditions. But we went to the mall, this place called Canal City, and they had a nice outdoor courtyard and a water fountain. This kid was just playing in the fountain, running around, cooling off. And the look on his face was priceless. And I think the reason I like this photo so much is that it really captured that moment, that sort of just sheer joy of being a little boy running around, cooling off in a water fountain. And I think that's the beauty of photography. This moment will never exist again. If you know this kid, then yeah, let me know who he is. But to me, this was the first photo that I took where I realized, hey, you know what, there's something really special here. Up until that point, I had taken photos of buildings and landscapes and other things that were kind of innocuous. And some of those pictures were really good, and I felt something with them for sure. But this was the first time that I had a real human connection with my photos. It was an irreplaceable moment that had happened. And it really opened up my eyes to this as a profession and what photography meant to me as a person. And I've always held this photo very close. No matter what has changed in the world of photography, this will always be one of my favorite pictures. So traveling in Japan at that time, primarily alone, became a great place to take pictures. It was a way that I could capture what I was seeing. It made things feel important. It made things feel shareable. And of course, now we have a whole different world where I could have shared this picture on Instagram immediately from my camera or phone. But at the time, I didn't see this photo until probably a few weeks or maybe even a couple months after, because I think when I came home from this trip, I had to save up and process the 23 or 25 rolls of film that I had shot while I was away. So there was no immediate gratification, but when I saw this picture, I knew this was a photo that it would carry with me for a long time. It is my intention to give you more technical detail as well on how these photos were taken, but I chose this one as the first one, even though I don't have any of that information, because it's just a photo that means something to me. And I think that's the most important place to start here. And I promise I'll share some other details with future photos, but with this one, I can't tell you anything other than I know it was shot on film, it was probably Fuji film, and it was probably Fuji consumer, maybe Superia, something like that, something consumer grade. I had no idea what it was gonna look like at the time. I don't even know if I knew what I was doing. It was probably shot in P mode, but the moment was the most important thing. And I think that this will always be a photo that I hold close to me just because it not only reminds me of a time and place, and I do think it is actually a great photo, but this was the moment that I wanted to become a photographer. So technical details aside, I promise I'll share some of that stuff with you on future photos, but this one, this is definitely a keeper for me, and this is where I wanted to start that series. So that's just a little story about a photo, but a significant photo to me, and I'd love to hear what you have to say about it, and I'd love to hear what you think about the actual picture and about how things have changed in photography, and whether you missed the film days. Did you even ever shoot on film? I don't know. But yeah, I'm gonna make this an ongoing series. It's something that I think I've never really talked about my work, and it's something that I'd like to share with you. And if you're interested, please subscribe, like the video, send me some notes. I'd love to hear your feedback. Thanks very much.